Hi, this is Stephanie Miller from The Stephanie Miller Show. Please enjoy this exclusive clip from my show on Political Voices Network. Let's see where we are. It's Trump Convicted Felon Week.
All right.
Here on The Stephanie Miller Show. Look, I've started my... You can get all of these fantastic shirts. Shadow for Delicious, Donnie Dalhan's Off the Cuff Tour. You can get these at stephaniemiller.com. Neil Katyal, Legal Lad.
We're finally at closing arguments after Trump's repeated attempts to delay this, to stop this trial, even just a couple days ago, rushing to the Court of Appeals, saying the judge has to be recused for bias and stuff. All of that has been beaten back by the Court of Appellate Court in New York. And so now we are finally going to get to closing arguments. And I think what the Trump defense is going to do is basically to say, this is not a case about Donald Trump. It's a case about Michael Cohen. And they put Michael Cohen on trial. They'll call him a liar. They'll say he was convicted because he was a liar, that he's in it for his own ends, that he's in it for ego because he's not a spurned lover, but a spurned lawyer by Donald Trump and the like.
I don't think that's going to go well. One more.
And what the prosecution is going to say, picking up on what Andrew said just a moment ago, and I totally agree with it, is that this is not just a case about Michael Cohen. It's a case about Michael Cohen plus. Cohen is just gravy. And it's things like the Hope Hicks testimony that Andrew referred to, but it's also handwritten notes that we've got and those checks that you just flashed on the screen a moment ago, which picks up on paragraph 33 in the complaint. These are checks that Donald Trump himself signed. And so that shows knowledge of the whole scheme. And I think at the end of the day, the Trump defense is going to play trying to get to beyond a reasonable doubt, just getting one juror who's going to say, hey, I disagree, because in our system, that means you can't put him in jail. And the prosecution is going to say, hey, this is common sense. We're talking about a guy, Donald Trump, who watched every penny. Do you really think that he would have been cool with all this money going out of his account without knowing it? Do you really think he would just reimburse $430,000 or whatever that number is without some knowledge about what was going on? Of course not. So it's a common sense case, and I suspect that it's going to be successful.
He's a penny pincher and a micromanager.
Yeah exactly. Here's a happy clappy thought to end this segment on. Okay. John Cooper says if Trump loses in November, he'll stand trial in 2025 for all his crimes, both state and federal. The bottom line is if Trump loses, he's going to prison. That's another reason to vote for Biden. I'm sorry, I'm a little giddy. I feel like Trump's going to be a convicted felon by the end of the...
Correct.
Oh my God, there's a story, the Biden camp, like, oh, they're deciding whether they should, you know, go with calling him a convicted felon. Yes!
Yes!
Embrace your inner Jasmine Crockett.
Do it.
Yes! Oh my God. Absolutely. I mean, yes, you got to run on other things, but guess what? Joe Biden's doing great on all those other things too.
Exactly.
But no one seems to care about, you know, I literally, David Ferguson, get him, I heard him on you with you and Bob Seska saying Democrats should stop talking about how good the economy is because people just don't think so. And then you made that sound, whatever it is that.
Oh,
sound.
The new one. I have it on.
Yeah.
This
do you
computer.
Have it? Yeah. It's.
It's a new one.
Or you could make the new one.
I have it. I can give it to you later.
To explain the guttural sound that came from Jody Hamilton. She's such a nice girl. You wouldn't expect it.
Yes. Yeah. It's like the Spanish Inquisition.
It's like Linda Blair in The Exorcist.
Okay. Pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, but yeah, it's just, it's so frustrating, you know, when you see polling going, oh, people don't think the economy, blah, blah, blah. I get it, but all we can do is talk about what the provable statistics are. I get it. We can talk about greedflation. I get it that people feel like, but that's not Joe Biden's fault.
No, it's not.
The parts of, anyway, but he was just like, oh, we shouldn't, Democrats should stop saying the economy's good. Really? If it was a Republican, they wouldn't mention that the unemployment got to almost 13% under the predecessor and is now 3%.
Right.
Stock market through the roof, wages up, inflation down. Really? If it was the Republican candidate, they wouldn't talk about that, about how great the record is. So what, Democrats were supposed to not? Like, we're supposed to be like, Stewart and Mad TV. Had it. Okay.
One more thing. You mentioned Jasmine Crockett.
Yes.
There's an article in the LA Times this morning about how some lesbians are upset that she used the word butch.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. Butch up, ladies.
Yeah.
I'm a lesbian. Butch up. Okay.
You're of the lipstick variety, though.
Yes.
Yes.
Wee. I'm a girl. Okay. According to... Although those nails, that's the big tell that she's a straight girl.
Because
I was
nails.
Like, Leah, Lord. Edwina Scissorhands. Get out.